In this video, you will learn how to create custom paper sizes for the Microsoft Print to PDF printer. The Windows system provides a lot of predefined paper formats and you can even create your own paper sizes. However, most of these system-wide defined formats aren't even available in the paper size dropdown of the Microsoft PDF printer. But there is another virtual printer called Microsoft XPS Document Writer, which is configured in a way that it can access all the paper sizes defined on the system. So what we will do is, we will overwrite the printer configuration of the Microsoft Print to PDF printer with the more flexible configuration of the Microsoft XPS Document Writer. Like that, the Microsoft PDF printer will also be able to access all the formats which are defined in the system, even the custom ones that we will create at the end of this video. To start, click into the Windows search bar, type in Registry, and then open the Registry Editor. Now open the local machine folder, System, Current control set, control, print, printers, and then click on the Microsoft Print to PDF folder. You don't have to open this folder, just click on it so that you can see its registry values. Then open the Windows Explorer, go to the hard drive where Windows is installed, then into the Windows folder, System32, spool, and finally V4. Switch back to the registry editor and check the values of the printqv4 driver directory. This is the name of the folder that contains the settings for the Microsoft Print to PDF printer, and therefore we have to open that folder in the Windows Explorer. I'm actually doing a right click on that folder and select Open in New Tab, as we will need to open another one. Now go back to the registry editor again and click on Microsoft XPS Document Writer. There, again search for the printqv4 driver directory value and open the corresponding folder in the Windows Explorer. So far, we opened the configuration folder of the Microsoft Print to PDF printer, as well as the Microsoft XPS Document Writer. In the folder of the Microsoft Print to PDF printer, make a copy of the GDP file so that you have a backup in case something in the following steps gets messed up. Afterwards, click into the Windows search bar, search for Notepad, do a right-click on it, and select Run as Administrator. Then, within Notepad, click on File, Open, navigate to the Configuration folder of the Microsoft Print to PDF printer, select the file type All Files, then select the GDP file and click on Open. Now, switch to the folder of the Microsoft XPS Document Writer and also open its GDP file. Since you won't be editing this one, it doesn't matter if you open it with admin rights or not. Finally, delete all the content from the Microsoft Print to PDF printer configuration file, copy the configuration code from the XPS Document Writer, and paste it into the empty configuration file of the Microsoft PDF printer. Then scroll down to where it says Model Name, go back into the folder of the Microsoft PDF printer and open the backup file. Copy the model name from the backup file and paste it into the file you just edited. Now scroll to the very bottom of the backup file, copy the print schema namespace parameter and again paste it into the other file. Afterwards, you can save the edited GDP file of the Microsoft Print to PDF printer and close all the files. If you now use the Microsoft PDF printer, you will notice that you already have a lot more paper sizes available, since the printer can now access every format that is saved on your system. So if you want to use a custom paper size, you now simply have to add it to the system and it will be available for the PDF printer. To add a new paper size to the system, click into the Windows search bar, type in Printers and click on Printers and Scanners. Here, scroll down to the bottom and open Print Server Properties. In the Forms tab, check the box which says Create a New Form, give it a name and set the paper size. Finally, click on OK and this new custom format will be available for the PDF printer. And just a quick message to you out there who is watching this video. Researching all the content for that specific video and creating it took several hours of time. And since this is a tutorial for a very specific problem, it won't get many views and therefore it usually wouldn't even be worthwhile creating it. I still created it since there is only very limited information about this topic out there. So with you being one of the few viewers of this video, if I was able to solve your issue, then please return me the favor by subscribing to the channel, giving the video a thumbs up, and maybe leaving a quick confirmation in the comments that this solution works. Without that support from you guys, the creation of such super specific videos is unfortunately just not worth it. Thanks a lot, and I see you in the next one.